ASH 2015 coverage continues here in Orlando, Florida. I'm Thomas Baldrick, and we are honored to have with us Dr. Anna Falanga. She is basically chief of everything at the Hospital Papa Giovanni in Italy. What's it like to be queen of a whole place?
Well, no, it's not a queen. In just normal life, it's getting old, you know, the responsibility can increase, and it's nice when you are a woman to do a career, because this is not very, very easy still today, because many women get the degree in medicine, but not many continue and have a career like men. So I think I could do that, and I am very happy with that.
I'm sure it's gotten easier over the years, huh?
No, it's not easy. It's not easy. Yeah. It's not easy for the private life, for the family, for all things that one has to do. Plus, my husband is a medical doctor too, so very busy as well. And with, you know, on-call problems, and so it's difficult to grow up children. But at the end, we succeeded.
And you've got the added responsibility now of being a role model.
Yes. I have in nearby Milan, in Bergamo, the Papa Giovanni Hospital is a large hospital in North Italy. And I am the chief of the Department of Transfusion Medicine and the Thrombosis and Hemostasis Center.
Very good.
Okay.
Let's talk about the poster you presented here at ASH about VTE biomarkers in metastatic cancer. Mm-hmm. Why is this an important topic?
Well, this is a topic that I have always been involved in coagulation in my life, but particularly my specific research topic is cancer-associated thrombosis and bleeding. There are many interactions between the coagulation system and the malignant tissues. So they kind of activate each other. So the thrombotic system, the coagulation system, helps the cancer to grow and spread out and form metastasis all over. But also the presence of the cancer activates coagulation and increases the risk of having thrombosis and sometimes thrombohemorrhagic syndromes. So it is important to understand the mechanism, because it can give us the key for new approaches to stop malignancy, first of all, but also to decrease this inconvenience of an increased thrombotic tendency in this subject, because the occurrence of thrombosis, of course, is something that disturbs very much the course of the disease with symptoms, but also interferes with the chemotherapy schedule, with delays in the treatments. So it is important to stop also the complications. But the final goal would be to stop cancer.
What are some of the highlights from the poster you have here?
The presentation, I have the presentation here. We are conducting a very large study, a multicenter study in Italy, to understand whether thrombotic markers in the blood can predict the diagnosis of cancer in normal subjects, or they can predict for survival in patients that have already got the diagnosis of cancer. So this will involve thousands of people and a large population of a healthy subject, and also pretty large population of a cancer subject. So this is the first analysis we did on a subgroup of patients, the first that were enrolled into the cancer part of the study. So our cancer patients with the metastatic disease, and we could see that some of these thrombotic biomarkers can predict the occurrence of thrombosis during the follow-up. This can help to identify the patients at high risk, in whom probably the thromboprophylaxis can be useful for preventing these complications.
You've been at this niche for a while. Where are we today in understanding the cancer and thrombosis connection?
Well, we know a lot of more things. In the last 10, 15 years, there have been a lot of new findings. Particularly important is the regulation of the clotting proteins by oncogenes. So it's the same disease that causes cancer that make the cancer cell, not all of them, there are some differences, but in general, the malignant cell acquire a prothrombotic phenotype. And this is regulated by the oncogene often that also make the normal cell to change and become a malignant cell.
Dr. Flanga, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on your career as both a woman and a doctor.
Thank you.
And thanks for being an inspiration to both.
Thank you.
Okay.